rated universal. Good for general watching.
Game On is brought to you by...
Winning has never been this simple. Bet with 1xBet.
Game On. It's Game On. We are big on sports. Big on sports.
Well, Mali, Kenya, and certainly Rwanda, those are the three teams, yes, that have been drawn alongside the Uganda Cranes in Group E when it comes to the FIFA 2022, that is the World Cup qualifier. So we'll be discussing that and so much more. Up to 40 different sides are going to be involved in the FIFA 2022 World Cup qualifiers. I'll tell you what, starting March this particular year, all the way up until November next year, it's going to be quite the run of games for Jonathan McKinstry and his boys. So on the show today, we'll be exclusively talking about the World Cup qualifiers. Everything that should be expecting the journey to Qatar 2022 is almost upon us. But tell you what, on the show as well, the round of 64, when it comes to the Uganda Cup, there was a couple of games yesterday. Teams like Chigezi, sides like Proline certainly progressing into the next round. So action returns today and will be running for the rest of the week. Also on the show as well, later on, last night, Arsenal held to a 2-2 draw. That was at the Stamford Bridge, but had finished the game with 10 men, given David Luiz was sent off. So that and so much more up ahead. Welcome to the show. You're watching Game On, and it's a Wednesday. Certainly, my name is Bran Asimwe. I'll be joined by Hope for the next 1 hour. And remember, we're probably powered by 1xBet. So if you're looking to place a bet, there's a lot of football you have to do. Check out the 1xBet website, and you can definitely get to bet on all your favorite sports. So without any further ado, certainly Hope does get to join me on the show today. How are you doing, Hope? It's good to have you here.
Thank you, Bran. You look smart.
Thank you. You look amazing yourself.
Thank you so much. I'm really good.
Yeah, and it's good to have you. Usually I have you for Game On Fan Friday.
Yeah.
I've switched the script a little bit, and it's now Game On Weekdays. But hey, plenty of sports to discuss on the show today. Have you got any highlights for yourself?
Well, the highlights are always so many, and knowing that we are into the transfer window, for me, the best highlight of the week has to be Alan Okello moving away from KCCA. This is the most loved player in Uganda, the best player, I should say. Mm. And I think for me, I'm very happy for him. At his age, 19 years old, and all the things that he has achieved as a player, going into and looking for a new challenge is quite something good for him.
Interestingly, at 19, this kid has played more than 100 games for KCCA. And you're thinking, at his age, the kind of experience he's been able to garner, he's also played for the national team. Should we expect for him to do great things down in Algeria?
I think it's possible because, like I said, growing from a 17-year-old prospect, you know, to leading KCCA to all the trophies that I've won, all the years that he has been at KCCA, and he has great abilities, to be honest. For me, when you talk about this is a time, yes, this is his time, because for all the years that he has been at KCCA, he has been improving and evolving as a player, and I think for me that's the most important thing as a young player. Most of the times when a player is young, they tend to lose focus because they're achieving certain things, and if you look at Aaron Akero, like you said, all the things that he has achieved, you know, the inaugural football 2-5-6 player of the year, the same year he's the best player of, you know, Uganda, and the best player at KCC. I mean, he has been the best player at KCC, of course, alongside Mustafa Kiza. Before he left to Algeria, he was a top scorer with 6 goals and, you know, 10 assists, if I'm correct.
Yeah.
So if you look at all the things that he has achieved and, you know, going into a new challenge, I think for me the only thing he needs now, he's working on his physicality, which I think is a... It's different because in Algeria, the environment is different from what we have here in Uganda.
True.
And he's going to be facing a different opponents.
Yeah.
So I think for me, if he can work on that and work on his strength,
yeah,
because at times, like you said, if you look at football now, it has really evolved.
Right.
You cannot just depend on having the brains, having the right foot, you know, scoring goals. You also need that physical strength to be able to shoulder off your opponents.
All right, the conversation regarding Alan Okello does continue a little later on in the show. But for now, though, first things first, let's kick off with the news coming out of, sports, because what happens is the newly appointed state minister for sports, that is Honorable Hanson Obua, yesterday I did have a meeting with the stakeholders from the National Council of Sports, which is pretty much the body mandated to run sports on behalf of government, and they are empowered to grow the sport, to develop it as well. So he toured the facility down in Lugogo, And on top of that, he also had a meeting, a high-level meeting with the board, you know, of NCS Plus, the boss as well, that is Mr. Bosco Onyik. And they talked about so many different things regarding funding, regarding resource allocation, regarding infrastructure as well, among so many things to help the game of football grow in Uganda. Obviously, Honorable Charles Bakabulindi is out after 14 years. We've now got Honorable Hanson Obua coming into office. And yesterday, high-level meeting, so many things discussed. But the entire bottom line is to grow sports in Uganda. What should you make of Obua and the kind of strategy he should have as the new boss?
Well, I really can't underestimate whatever he said yesterday. And we should know that this is a guy who has been around the industry. He knows the system. He knows the ethics, you know, for the industry. So I think for me, you just have to look. Be patient and wait what he's going to do,
right,
you know, through his tenure, because we cannot say just because the other people failed to achieve or to do whatever they were supposed to do means that he's also going to fail. And for me, the one thing that he has been preaching ever since, you know, he was appointed the Minister of Sports, he has been talking about sports facilities. I remember last year when we were doing the show on Fanfare Day, last year when we were talking about the game that he watched with the President of Uganda at MTN Arena.
Yeah.
They left and, you know, I think they just saw how the place was and how it looked like. I mean, it needs some improvement. And I think for me, if they can really focus on that, he also talks about, you know, helping the federations understand their own structure, you know, studying it more and looking at the legal structure itself. So those have been some of the issues that have been facing the industry. So we're just going to wait and see what it's going to do for us.
Like you mentioned, he talks about facilities. That has been one of the biggest challenges. You know, there's a lot of talent. There's a lot of sport that could happen. The challenge has always been, where do these youngsters get to express themselves in terms of facilities? There's been a call for more infrastructure in terms of sport. And interestingly, the other thing that he did speak about was engaging the corporate bodies, you know, all these different stakeholders and sponsors that can come on board and inject money into the game of sports altogether, because he says he's willing to put himself out there and make sure that he talks to all these different companies. How important is it that all the stakeholders come together with one aim of growing sports in Uganda?
Of course, getting the stakeholders, they have to first improve the facilities. Facilities attract funds, and when the funds are there, you get sponsors. So I think that's one of the things, like he said and he mentioned it, that's one of the things that have first to work on, as they can look for sponsors. And then he also talked about something that federation should not be running to the government for money. I think there, if you tell the federation not to go to the government to ask for funds, I think it was quite wrong. Because we have to know, in Uganda, we don't have so many private companies investing a lot of money in the sports sector.
Yep.
So that's why you need the government's hand, you know, in this this time around. So if they can work, if they can give the accountability, and if the government is seeing some good performances coming through, there's nothing that should be stopping them from funding the sports industry.
All right, there you go. That is Honorable Hamson Obua. And we do await to see precisely what he brings to the table when it comes to sports in Uganda. But one thing we know, it's going to be a new chapter. He also gave a lot of applause to his predecessor, that is Honorable Charles Bakabulindi. But hey, that was the big high-level meeting that did happen yesterday, specifically to make sure that sports goes from where it is right now on to the next level in Uganda. But quickly, from that, let's talk a bit of Uganda Cup action right now. Because yesterday there was a bit of football that did get down in the round of 64. And some big performances, some big results as well for the big boys in the round of 64. And quickly, that should be a conversation we continue after the break. So when we come back after the break, look at the Uganda Cup, the defending champions Poland through to the round of 32. And also be talking at the FIFA 2022 World Cup qualifiers. For the Cranes, they're up against Mali, Kenya, and definitely Rwanda as well. So that and so much more after the break. You're watching Game On, powered by One Expert.
Game on. It's game on. We are big on sports. Big on sports.
Game On is brought to you by
Winning has never been this simple. Bet with